Hello students, my name is Nidhi Singh and I am from Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Hyderabad. In the current module, we will be learning about demographic and health survey from the paper Fertility. The broad learning objectives of the module would be overview of demographic and health survey, demographic and health survey programs and the supporting surveys, and the countries where demographic and health survey program is active. We will also learn about some special focus topics, demographic health survey in India, the types of demographic and health surveys, the topics covered under demographic health surveys, questionnaires and modules, and we learn about the NFHS surveys. The Demographic and Health Survey DHS program is responsible for collecting and disseminating accurate, nationally representative data on health and population in developing countries. The project is implemented by ICF International and is funded by the United States Agency for International Development, USAID, with contributions from other donors such as UNICEF, UNFPA, WHO and UNAIDS. The DHS is highly comparable to the multiple indicator cluster surveys, and the technical teams developing and supporting the survey are in close collaboration. Demographic and health surveys, therefore, are nationally representative household surveys that provide data for a wide range of monitoring and impact evaluation indicators in the areas of population, health, and nutrition. Since 1984, the Demographic and Health Surveys program has provided technical assistance to more than 300 demographic and health surveys in over 90 countries. DHS surveys collect information on fertility and total fertility rate, that is TFR, reproductive health, maternal health, child health, immunization and survival, HIV/AIDS, maternal mortality, child mortality, malaria and nutrition among women and children stunted. The strategic objective of the DHS program is to improve and institutionalize the collection and use of data by host countries for program monitoring and evaluation and for policy development decisions. Since September 2013, ICF International has been partnering with 7 internationally experienced organizations to expand access to and use of the DHS data. Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health Center for Communications Programs, Program for Appropriate Technology in Health, Avenir Health, Vicenova, Blue Raster, Chymetrica and Encompass. Surveys. The DHS program supports the following data collection options. Demographic and Health Survey, which provide data for monitoring and impact evaluation indicators in the areas of population, health and nutrition. AIDS Indicator Survey, AIS. These provide countries with a standardized tool to obtain indicators for the effective monitoring of national HIV/AIDS programs. Service Provision Assessment, SPA. These surveys provide information about the characteristics of health and family planning services available in a country. Malaria Indicator Surveys, MIS. They provide data on bed net ownership and use, prevention of malaria during pregnancy, and prompt and effective treatment of fever in young children. In some cases, biomarker testing for malaria and anemia are also included. Key Indicator Surveys, KIS. They provide monitoring and evaluation data for population and health activities in small areas, regions, district, catchment areas that may be targeted by an individual project, although they can be used in nationally representative surveys as well. Other quantitative data includes geographic data collection and benchmarking surveys, biomarker collection. In conjunction with surveys, more than 2 million tests have been conducted for HIV, anemia, malaria, and more than 25 other biomarkers. qualitative research, provides information outside the purview of standard quantitative approaches. Countries. The DHS program has been active in over 90 countries in Africa, Asia, Central Asia, West Asia, and Southeast Asia, Latin America, and the Caribbean. A list of the publications for each country is available online at the DHS program website. Now we'll have a look at the spatial focus topics under this module. HIV/AIDS. Since 2001, the DHS program has worked in over 15 countries in Africa, Asia, Latin America, and Caribbean, conducting population-based HIV testing. By collecting blood for HIV testing from representative samples of the population of men and women in a country, the DHS program provides nationally representative estimates of HIV rates. The testing protocol provides for anonymous, informed, and voluntary testing of women and men. The program also collects data on internationally recognized AIDS indicators. Currently, the main source of HIV/AIDS indicators in the database are the demographic and health surveys, the multiple indicator cluster surveys, the reproductive health surveys, the sexual behavior surveys, and the behavioral surveillance surveys. Eventually, it will cover all countries for which indicators are available. The project also collects data on the capacity of healthcare facilities to deliver HIV prevention and treatment services. Malaria. Since 2000, DHS and some AIS surveys have collected data on ownership and use of mosquito nets, treatment of fever in children, and intermittent preventive treatment of pregnant women. In recent years, additional questions on indoor residual spraying and biomarker testing for anemia and malaria have been conducted. This has, however, not changed the trend in malaria infections, thereby calling for more interventions by researchers and scientists. Gender. The DHS program researches and trains for integrating gender into population, health, and nutrition programs and HIV/AIDS related activities in the developing world. Questions on gender roles and empowerment are integrated into most DHS questionnaires. For countries interested in more in-depth data on gender, modules of questions are available on specific topics such as status of women, domestic violence, and female genital mutilation. Youth. The DHS program has interviewed thousands of young people and gathered information about their education, employment, media exposure, nutrition, sexual activity, fertility, unions, and general reproductive health, including HIV prevalence. The Youth Corner on the DHS website presents findings about youth and features profiles of young adults aging between 15 to 24 from more than 30 countries. The Youth Corner is part of the broader effort by the Interagency Youth Working Group to help program managers, donors, national and local governments, teachers, religious leaders, and non-governmental organizations plan and implement programs to improve the reproductive health of young adults. Geographic information. The DHS program now analyzes the impact of geographic location using DHS data and Geographic Information System, that is GIS. The DHS program routinely collects geographic information in all surveyed countries. Using GIS, researchers can link DHS data with routine health data, health facility locations, local infrastructure such as roads and rivers, and environmental conditions. Biomarkers. Using field-friendly technologies, the DHS program is able to collect biomarker data relating to conditions and infections. DHS surveys have tested for anemia by measuring hemoglobin, HIV infection, sexually transmitted diseases such as syphilis and the herpes simplex virus, vitamin A, lead exposure, high blood pressure, and immunity from vaccine preventable diseases like measles and tetanus. Traditionally, much of the data gathered in DHS surveys is self-reported. Biomarkers complement this information by providing an objective profile of a specific disease or health condition in a population. Biomarker data contributes to the understanding of behavioral risk factors and determinants of different illnesses. The data. The DHS program works to provide survey data for program managers, healthcare providers, policy makers, country leaders, researchers, members of the media, and others who can act to improve public health. The DHS program distributes unrestricted survey data files for legitimate academic research at no cost. Online databases include STAT compiler, STAT mapper, that is STAT compiler, STAT mapper, HIV and AIDS survey indicator database, HIV spatial data repository, HIV mapper, and country quick stats. Publications. The DHS program produces publications that provide country-specific and comparative data on population, health, and nutrition in developing countries. Most publications are available online for download, but if an electronic version of the publication is not available, a hard copy may be available. Now we'll have a look at the demographic and health surveys in India. Health information gathering is an important part of any health system, but is often weak in low-income countries, plagued by poor quality data that are inadequate for informing health policy. Population-based surveys are an invaluable source of health information. A key aim of these surveys is to provide high-quality data for policy development and program planning, monitoring, and evaluation. Population-based surveys have been used extensively to gather information on fertility, mortality, family planning, maternal and child health nutrition in India. A large-scale and benchmark demographic health sample survey have been carried out from time to time by different agencies in different parts of India covering different segments of population. The demographic sample surveys conducted from time to time are helpful to examine the linkages between fertility and its proximate variables to identify and assess the importance of socio-economic and cultural variables affecting fertility and mortality, to assess the factors and prospects in the composition of the population in various subgroups, and also to gain an understanding of the determinants of fertility level in population. Now let us have a look at the DHS survey types. There are two types of DHS surveys, standard DHS surveys and interim DHS surveys. Standard DHS surveys have large sample sizes and are typically conducted about every 5 years to allow comparisons over time. Interim DHS surveys focus on the collection of information on key performance monitoring indicators, but may not include data for all impact evaluation measures. These surveys are conducted between rounds of DHS surveys and have shorter questionnaires than DHS surveys. Although nationally representative, these surveys generally have smaller samples than DHS surveys. The DHS program provides capacity strengthening to host country implementing agencies through all survey stages, including survey design and sampling, training, field work, data tabulation and analysis, report writing, and dissemination and use of findings. The DHS program implements multiple surveys, including demographic and health survey, malaria indicator survey, service provision assessment survey, Now we'll cover the DHS survey topics. Information is available for the following topics, among others: anemia, including prevalence of anemia and iron supplementation; child health, including vaccinations, childhood illness, newborn care; domestic violence, prevalence of domestic violence and consequences; education, literacy, attendance, highest level achieved; environmental health, including water, sanitation and cooking fuel; family planning, knowledge and use of contraceptives; female genital cutting, prevalence of and attitudes about female genital cutting; fertility and fertility preferences, including total fertility rate, desired family size, marriage and sexual activity; gender domestic violence, including history of domestic violence, frequency and consequences of violence; HIV/AIDS knowledge, attitudes and behavior, including knowledge of HIV prevention, misconceptions, stigma, higher risk sexual behavior and previous HIV testing; HIV prevalence, prevalence of HIV by demographic and behavior characteristics; household and respondent characteristics, including electricity, housing quality, possessions, education and school attendance, age, sex, employment; infant and child mortality, infant and child mortality rates; malaria, ownership and use of mosquito nets, prevalence and treatment of fever, indoor residual spraying of mosquitoes; maternal health, antenatal delivery and postnatal care; maternal mortality, including maternal mortality ratio; nutrition, including child feeding practices, vitamin supplementation; anthropometry, anemia and salt iodization; tobacco use, tobacco use and exposure to secondhand smoke; unmet need for family planning; wealth, division of households into 5 wealth quintiles to show relationship between wealth, population and health indicators; women's empowerment; gender attitude, women's decision making power; education and employment of men versus women; and other modules including fistula, health expenditures. DHS has earned a worldwide reputation for collecting and disseminating accurate, nationally representative data on fertility, family planning, maternal and child health, gender, HIV/AIDS, malaria and nutrition. DHS surveys collect primary data using 4 types of model questionnaire. A household questionnaire is used to collect information on characteristics of the household's dwelling unit and characteristics of usual residents and visitors. It is also used to identify members of the household who are eligible for an individual interview. Eligible respondents are then interviewed using an individual women's or man's questionnaire. The biomarker questionnaire is used to collect biomarker data on children, women and men. For special information on topics that are not contained in the model questionnaire, optional questionnaire modules are available. Interviews are conducted only if the respondent provides voluntary informed consent. DHS model questionnaires. Most country surveys collect information on basic demographic and health topics. The model questionnaires of the DHS program emphasize basic indicators and flexibility. In a majority of DHS surveys, people eligible for individual interview include women of reproductive age between 15 to 49 years and men age in the groups of 15 to 49 years, 15 to 54 years or 15 to 59 years. Individual questionnaires include information on fertility, mortality, family planning, marriage, reproductive health, child health, nutrition and HIV/AIDS. Some countries have a need for special information on topics that are not contained in the model questionnaire. To accommodate this need and to achieve some level of comparability across countries, that have a need to collect such data, optional questionnaire modules address various additional topics. In addition, country-specific questions are typically added to meet local conditions and needs. The questionnaires used in one country, while containing essentially the same information, may be different in many ways from those used in another country. It is also important to understand that the model questionnaires change over time. The model questionnaires and questionnaire modules have changed with each DHS phase, and the current DHS-7 questionnaires have changed substantially from those used in the first phase of DHS conducted in the 1980s. We'll have a look at the household questionnaire topics. The household questionnaires contain information on the following topics. For usual members of the household and visitors, information is collected about age, sex, relationship to the head of the household, education, parental survivorship and residence, and birth registration. Household characteristics. Questions asked about the source of drinking water, toilet facilities, cooking fuel, assets of the household, and exposure to secondhand smoke. Cooking salt is tested for iodine content. In areas with a high prevalence of malaria, questions are asked about the use of mosquito nets. Women's questionnaire topics. The women's questionnaire contain information on the following topics. Background characteristics. Questions on age, marital status, education, employment, media exposure, and place of residence provide information on characteristics likely to influence demographic and health behavior. Reproductive behavior and intentions. Questions cover dates and survival status of all births, pregnancies that did not end in a live birth, current pregnancy status, fertility preferences, and future childbearing intentions of each woman. Contraception. Questions cover knowledge and use of specific contraceptive methods, source of contraceptive methods, exposure to family planning messages, informed choice, and unmet need for family planning. For women not using contraception, questions are included on knowledge of a source of contraception. Antenatal delivery and postnatal care. The questionnaire collects information on antenatal and postnatal care, place of delivery, who attended the delivery, birth weight, and the nature of complications during pregnancy for recent births. Breastfeeding and nutrition. Questions cover feeding practices, the length of breastfeeding, children's consumption of liquids and solid food, and micronutrient supplementation. Children's health. Questions examine immunization coverage, vitamin A supplementation, recent occurrences of diarrhea, fever, and cough for young children, and treatment of childhood diseases. Status of women. The questionnaire asks about various aspects of women empowerment, including decision making, autonomy, ownership of houses and land, barriers to medical care, and attitude towards domestic violence. HIV and other sexually transmitted infections. Questions assess women's knowledge of HIV and other sexually transmitted infections, the source of their knowledge about HIV, knowledge about ways to avoid contracting HIV, HIV testing, stigma and discrimination, and high-risk sexual behavior. Husband's background. Currently, married women are asked about the age, education, and occupation of their husbands. Other topics include questions examining behavior related to environmental health, the use of tobacco, and health insurance. Now we'll have a look at the men's questionnaire topics. The men's questionnaire is similar to but shorter than the women's questionnaire. It collects information on the following topics. Background characteristics. Question on age, education, employment status, marital status, media exposure, and place of residence are included to provide information on characteristics likely to influence men's behavior. Reproduction. data collected on the number of children that the man has fathered in his lifetime, survival status of the births, number of women he has fathered children with, antenatal and delivery care for the last child born in the previous 3 years, and his knowledge on feeding practices for children with diarrhea. Questions are also asked about fertility preferences and future childbearing intentions of each man. Knowledge and use of contraception. Questions are designed to determine knowledge and use of specific family planning methods. Men are also asked about their exposure to family planning messages through both the media and health professionals, about the most fertile days in a women's cycle, and condom sources. Employment and gender roles. Men are asked about their employment and occupation, as well as about their attitude towards various aspects of women empowerment, such as decision making, childbearing, women's autonomy, and domestic violence. HIV and other sexually transmitted infections. Questions assess men's knowledge of HIV and other sexually transmitted infections, the sources of their knowledge about HIV, knowledge about ways to avoid contracting HIV, HIV testing, stigma and discrimination, and high-risk sexual behavior. Other health issues. Men are asked about various health issues such as circumcision, injections, use of tobacco, health insurance, and health and care for their children. Now let us discuss the biomarker questionnaire topics. The biomarker questionnaires contain information on the following topics: anthropometry, measuring the height and weight of children, women and men to determine their nutritional status; anemia, hemoglobin level in the blood is measured using a finger stick capillary blood sample. The level of hemoglobin is used to determine whether or not the respondent is anemic. Results are shared with the adult respondent, the minor respondent, and parent guardian of the minor respondent, and the parent guardian of the child. A blood sample is only collected if voluntary informed consent is provided. HIV. A capillary blood sample is collected on a filter paper card, dried overnight, and the dried blood sample is sent to a laboratory for HIV prevalence testing. Results of the testing are kept completely anonymous and cannot be identified with the respondent. A blood sample is only collected from a respondent who has provided voluntary informed consent. Respondents eligible for collection of DBS are those who are respondent to the women's and men's questionnaire. Questionnaire modules. Optional modules are available on a variety of topics. Many original modules have been incorporated in the core questionnaire. Questionnaire modules for DHS 7 surveys are currently in a review. The current modules include topics such as domestic violence, female genital cutting, maternal mortality, fistula, out-of-pocket health expenditures. Modules from previous phases include consanguinity, domestic violence, female genital cutting, malaria, maternal mortality, pill failure and behavior, sterilization experience, women's status. But until 1992-93, the National Census was the only source of statistics which reported only the growing numbers and not the factors involved. Detailed statistics regarding utilization of family planning measures, reasons for non-use of available methods, type of methods preferred, etc. were all unaccounted for. Today, the policymakers can say whether it is popular belief, lack of access, lack of awareness, or familial disapproval that keep both men and women from implementing family planning measures. All of this is being made possible through extensive sample surveys conducted by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare called the National Family Health Surveys. What is NFHS? NFHS was started by Government of India in 1992-93 as the first large-scale multi-round household survey conducted at a national level. It was done in a representative sample of households throughout India and has been conducted 4 times since then. The National Family Health Survey is a large-scale multi-round survey conducted in a representative sample of households throughout India. The NFHS is a collaborative project of the International Institute of Population Sciences, Mumbai, ORC Macro, Calverton, Maryland, USA, and the East-West Center, Honolulu, Hawaii, USA. The Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, designated IIPS as the nodal agency responsible for providing coordination and technical guidance for the NFHS. NFHS was funded by the United States Agency for International Development with supplementary support from UNICEF. IIPS collaborated with a number of field organizations for survey implementation. Each field organization was responsible for conducting survey activities in one or more states covered by NFHS. The first NFHS was an important component of the project to strengthen the survey research capabilities of the Population Research Centers, PRCs, in India, launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, in 1991. Four rounds of surveys have been conducted since the first survey in 92-93. NFHS 1 in 1992-93, NFHS 2 in 1998-99, NFHS 3 in 2005-06, NFHS 4 in 2015-16. The survey provides states and national information for India on fertility, infant and child mortality, the practice of family planning, maternal and child health, reproductive health, nutrition, anemia, utilization and quality of health and family planning services. Each successive round of the NFHS has had two specific goals. A. To provide essential data on health and family welfare needed by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and other agencies for policy and program purposes. And B. To provide information on important emerging health and family welfare issues. Technical assistance for the NFHS was provided mainly by ORC Macro, USA, and other organizations on specific issues. The funding for different rounds of NFHS has been provided by USAID, DFID, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, UNICEF, UNFPA, and Ministry of Family and Health Welfare, Government of India. The NFHS is discussed in detail in other modules. Thank you.